This is Leonard Bernstein, and I'm going to tell you the story of Peter and the Wolf. Now, usually before this piece begins, the speaker explains how each person or animal in the story is described by a certain instrument of the orchestra. But I'm sure you know all that already, don't you? Well, all right, let's see if you do. For instance, who's being represented by these three French horns? Right, the wolf. And what is this oboe describing? Right again, the duck. And now the flute? You're batting 1,000, the bird. Now, who's this low character in the clarinet? Right, the cat. Then, of course, there are these well-known drum beats. What's that all about? Correct, the hunters shooting their guns. Now, who is this lumbering old bassoon? The grandfather. My, you really know this piece, don't you? Well, that's all of them. Except, wait, I left out the most important one of all, the strings. And that is Peter himself. I congratulate you on a perfect quiz. And now the story begins. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went into the big green meadow next to his house. The first friend he met was a little bird sitting on the branch of a big tree. The bird was chirping away happily. All is quiet, all is quiet, all is quiet, all is quiet. Yes, all was quiet. Even the pond was still, because there wasn't a breath of wind to ruffle it. soon a duck came waddling around. She lived in Peter's backyard, and she was glad that Peter had forgotten to close the gate, because now she could take a nice swim in the deep, still pond that was in the middle of the meadow. The little bird spied the duck and flew down next to her on the grass. "Huh," said the bird, "what kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" "Huh," answered the duck, "what kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" And she dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming around the pond and the little bird hopping after her along the shore. All of a sudden, something else caught Peter's attention. There was a cat sneaking through the grass. The cat thought, while the bird is busy arguing with the duck, I'll just grab him. And she slowly crept towards the bird on her velvet paws. "Look out!" yelled Peter to the bird, who immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck swam as fast as she could to the middle of the pond where the cat couldn't touch her, and quacked at the cat with all her might. But the cat was more interested in the bird. She crawled round the tree and thought, "Is it worth climbing up so high? By the time I get there, the bird will have flown away."